screen share now. By the way, if you're doing screen share from QuickTime, this is how you end it. You go all the way up to your bar and you press the stop button, which I'm obviously not going to do. Let's talk about screen share recording for Zoom, which is one of my favorite features of it. So you go to screen share only under host a meeting. So again, say I'm in regular Zoom, because this is probably confusing to folks. I'm gonna sign in again. You sign in through the washington.zoom.us. You should be forced to sign in through your UW email in order to get to Zoom Pro, which is what the UW's provided. Your landing page is here. My other video already told you how to edit all of these different settings, so you're welcome to check out there. Right now, I just want to show you really quickly how you can host a meeting that's screen share and have it also be with video on. So up here, you go to host a meeting, to the upper right. You go to screen share only, and you click on it. Now again, some folks prefer to have this run in their web browser dialog system. I've heard people say it's less glitchy. I find it to be the opposite. I think that it can be a little bit too dependent on the web browser. I don't like it. All right, go to open or create. You can actually have it connect via AirPlay, meaning a function on your Apple device if you're running through it on a different device. Most of you, that's gonna be overly complicated. So you can just select desktop and then it will follow and record whatever you need. Again, always remember, join with computer audio, unmute yourself, start video, go over to this corner here, right? Go to show video panel, expand it. Hi everybody, here I am again. Mute yourself when you need to, unmute yourself when you need to, toggle, play around with this however you want. But this can be nice because you can, on your own screen, actually do some annotations. Let me find something that's appropriate now to annotate for you. Let's look at, let's just look at this. Okay, let's do a notation on the kind of welcome screen that I'm using, right? So you see the screen, you go to annotate, and now you can take pointers like this and direct students' attention to things on the screen that you want them to note. This is useful for tutorials using things like Audacity or other materials that you need. This is useful if you already have a PowerPoint. You can click through it while you're talking, while your students can see you in the video in the far corner. If you're a student, this is beyond useful for your presentations. You can do an entire presentation where I see your face, I see you emoting, I understand what's happening. This is really productive because I can follow your PowerPoint, you can give me different visual cues, and I can still connect with you. Right, again, there's some accessibility frameworks that need to come in around this. They recommend checking out disability resource specialists. Be an advocate if emoting is something that you need to talk about in disability resources. But for now, be aware that this is a really good way to present without being able to be in person. And then the same tools that we looked at earlier are all available here. And then when you're done, you can just say, all right, I'm good now. So you can stop share. And it's safe. So those are a couple of screen sharing options, including whiteboard. I'm a pretty big fan of Zoom because of those. If you have all the settings from my other videos set up, it'll automatically save, so you don't have to toggle around figuring out how to save it while it's happening. So I can't recommend enough, if you know you will be using this tool regularly, that you go ahead and actually set those in advance so you don't have to think about it too much. That's what I've been doing. The last video I'm going to do is some basic preferences for if you're going to do a webcam, webinar, whatever it is, what you can do to help yourself look professional and put together if you don't have an entire studio set up.